the physical chemistry. So the real potential of the molecule, we synthesize different experimental conditions, different structures, different functional groups, different stereometry structures and all, but what happens to its physicochemical potential? Whether it sustains certain medium or certain experimental conditions, because ultimately we subject the molecule to the formulation. It is never in the pure state. So it is essential to understand its physicochemical potential. What happens when it is mixed with different medium, solvents or ingredients and pH and so many other things. So this ultimately the real word, the phycohacity means, I will go to this slide, better this slide. Suppose I take this, want some lettuce, sorry, here. For example, it is a mercury, 100% strongest cohesive forces. It is not of any use because surface energy is least. When surface energy is least, molecule will not respond to anything. So ultimately what we have to do, we have to enhance its surface energy by subjecting it to certain medium or certain conditions or pH. So what happens here, this is kind of a top to bottom, that we have to weaken the cohesive forces of this molecule, because pure form all cohesive forces are very stronger. And this molecule tries to reduce the least surface energy, and the material which is having least surface energy, least surface area is of no use. So nanoscience also said that it should have maximum surface area and maximum surface activities. So it is in that direction. So we have this cohesive force is not weakened, but it is transformed into the kinetic energy. How it is transformed into the kinetic energy? This is transformed the kinetic like this, 100% this contact angle very least, because strongest cohesive forces, so it is having very stronger cohesive force. Now when we are subjecting to different conditions, lower surface area, then what happens, it is gaining larger wettability or larger surface area. See this and this, if we see this least contact wettability, least, if we see this, wettability is highest. When wettability is highest, it means there are two types of functions. The friction is also there and the cohesivity is also there. So frictional as well as cohesive forces, the product of these forces is called phycohacity. The ultimate, the main purpose of this phycohacity is this, that we have to neutralize both the forces, the cohesive forces and the frictional forces or the wettability, and work is done. Why work is done? Because the cohesive forces is transformed into the work in wetting the surface area. It is the work is being done. So ultimately up to now people have been studying surface energy separately and shear stress separately, but we have to mix, we have to make the formulations. So this phycohacity, the real meaning of this phycohacity is this, we are here using the cohesive force, transform the cohesive force into the shear stress or frictional force. So that way it is the phycohacity. So as I told you that this is a top to down, top to down. We are reducing, we are making this formulation functional. It is not functional, it is non-functional. So this formulation, nano formulation is functional. And here also, suppose two are completely miscible, then what we have to do, then we have to create little bit adherent forces. So here it is a bottom to up. Certain solvent is also adhered around the nanoparticle, so that when it moves, a shear is generated. When shear is generated, then automatically cohesive force is already there, shear is there, so shear with the friction, so frictional and cohesive force become the phycohacity. That is the unique this thing. Similarly here, how it works, there are forces. Suppose chargement, negative positive, suppose another molecule and surface here, oppositely charged. So this kind of arrangement, quadrupolar arrangement, makes the molecule or makes the mercury to spread, because spontaneity generated Lee-Schertz, as per Lee-Schertz law, the gap and somewhere there's a maximum potential energy, somewhere there's no energy. So it, to fill up that gap, this comes here. Now same thing is here. It means the molecule should be completely, Professor Singh and Anil Kumar Singh sir were saying, the single molecule has a lot of potential. It has lot of potential only when it is monodispersed, because its surface area is fully ready to work. If many, it is a bulk material, its potential is utilized to engage same molecule. So there is no use of such technology. So now here we have seen that graphene, and the graphene was bulk, and when it did not reduce the methylene blue, we have conducted one experiment. But when we have completely exfoliated it, single layer, within 2-3 minutes, it has reduced. Next. So this is the fricohacity bag. So I tried to tell you that what is fricohacity, the product of frictional force and cohesive force. How it is a bag? That the solvent is also broken into smaller parts, adhere around the nanoparticles, and nanoparticles are already scared. So both, it is suspended, the solvent is making nanoparticle to suspend. However, it is entropy is very, very high. So nanoemulsions are thermodynamically and kinetically unstable. So we have also to see this thing. The same thing. The molecule, we have tried to dissolve the flavonoids in the water, but they were not dissolved. So what we have done, we used the interlocutor to change the surface energy of the water and the flavonoid itself. So DMSO acted as a stoichiometric, philic, phobic, stoichiometric balance. So it dissolved and made a perfect nanoemulsion transparent. Next. And this is the device. We have to track the cohesive forces and the frictional forces are the same amount in the same condition as a replica unit. It's a replica unit. So this here, this unit comes here, and sample is, this is called CPU. The important beauty of this device is that we can measure the physico-chemical parameters of inflammable liquid or any carcinogenous liquid, or any kind of liquid which is not possible outside, or redox kind of activities where molecules also photo optically very active outside. So in this device, molecules are easily, and it is a real recycle. Sample is taken here, and separate probes are fitted. In one probe it goes, we make the shear. It is a continuum process when liquid flow is continuum. This is the frictional or shear, and when it comes here, it is a non-continuum flow, because somewhere cohesive forces are to be expressed. So they are to be expressed in the non-continuum model or non-continuum mode. So this at the center here is measured that thing. So both this unit and these two units are replica, exactly replica. Whatever sample we are taking, they are put in these two units, and the conditions are also same. There is no any kind of kinetic loss in the sample, because completely uniform capillary, and completely there is no any 90 angle arrangement in this, no shocking or no mechanical shock to the molecule. So that's why this is perfectly measuring the real, the chemical, sir, cohesive force and the frictional force as such. So the product of these two become the fricohacity. So this device is also new. Sir, next slide. This is basically here, the quadrupolar arrangement here. This quadrupolar arrangement means that one opening here. So expression that, as I told you, cohesive forces, they are at the center. No pressure fluctuation, exactly the same. Whatever pressure fluctuation there, all openings are balancing that. So this unit becomes highly reproducible and highly accurate. Now, Lecomte measured the surface area or surface energy or surface tension or cohesive force. He assumed that the platinum-iridium plate, it is having contact angle zero, but it is not possible at all. So So he used this theory. Gamma means the surface energy, F force, which is used for lifting up this this ring is the platinum iridium ring. And he assumed that this theta, contact angle theta, when it is put in the sample and what is taken out, there should not be any contact, zero angle, but no, it is not possible. So there was a mistake in this. Back. While in this device, no such fault or no such error. Perfectly accurate. In fact, it is also balancing.
Next, sir.
So this device measures, if the name of this device is service meter. Why it is service meter? SUR stands for all surface related properties. The surface area, the surface energy, and the surface activation energy also. And VIS, the distribution, the coagulation, the coalescence, whatever activities are being done in the sample, all are tracked as such. So that's why viscosity does not mean viscosity, but shear or distribution factor.
Next, sir.
So now what is the, how we can say that when surface cohesive force is decreased, then surface area is increased. How we can say this graph that is the same? This graph says when surface cohesive force is decreased, when cohesive force is decreased, it will unfold or surface area will gain larger surface area. So this larger surface area is obtained here. Yes, sir. Similarly, also here. See, this is the here surface area, and when this is the cohesive force, when we are decreasing the cohesive force in terms of surface excess concentration, in the same ratio it is increasing. So this is fact. We have conducted so many experiments. Surface area accurately determined. Why? Because when the surface or cohesive forces are weakened or not weakened, transformed into kinetic energy, then surface area increases. Your molecular formulation becomes highly useful, applied industrially potential.
Next, sir.
So this is, we have conducted this experiment. We have prepared curcumin nanoemulsion by adding glycerol, ethanol and water. We wanted, in generally it is seen that when we raise temperature, what happens that cohesive force is decreased. But it was a reverse trend here. We were surprised to see that why the surface energy, surface tension is decreasing. Then we reached on the conclusion by conducting many experiments that here the water, which was suspended water here, it came out when we reached the temperature. There were motions, translatory and other molecular motions. Because of these molecular motions, the water came out. When water came out, then it has increased its surface energy. It has increased cohesive force. When it has increased cohesive force, then surface tension is increased. So it was the reason of this. Similarly, this device also very accurately measures the CMC. The another important factor is this. When we take increase the alkyl chain, alkyl chain, this octyl, trinitryl, ammonium bromide, this is syringe, increasing. So what happens if we have a calibration of the certain surfactants in the increasing order of the carbon number in the alkyl chain? Once calibration is there, you can also determine the number of carbon atoms in the alkyl chain by fitting this equation. This is very, very important calibration.
Next, sir. Same.
Now, this is very useful for farmers. What happens when, as I already told you, larger size, bulk, as sir you were saying, the bulk. Well, bulk is there, cohesive force is very larger, wettability is least. No use of this formulation. So if farmers want to make a pesticide nanoemulsion spreading larger area, then they have to use this, they have to come to this side. Well, if surface energy is least, wettability is maximum. This wettability is here the maximum. So such formulations are required for the farmers. Because larger surface area will be covered, least amount of pesticide will be used, and then definitely it's a smart technology. Next, sir. Same thing is also here, nanoemulsion. Not very surprising. Sir, we say that the sodium explosive reaction in the water, I'm 100% sure, if we bake a nanoemulsion by taking certain organic molecule, I'm 100% sure we can, there will be no explosive reaction. This is a challenging question.
We
put in the water, explosive reaction, because electron action, hydrogen produced. There's no question. But if we make, it means if we make water which is not freely available, it is fully engaged in the nanoemulsion. So what the moment what is available, then it will immediately react with the sodium. So if we strongly enter the water in the nanoemulsion, I am sure that rather than in kerosene, we can also in nanoemulsion store this sodium in the nanoemulsion.
Next, sir.
This is, sir, just a funny question. The tears of wine. This is based on the service meter, sir. Tears of wine. With ethanol, water, and surface energy of water 72 millinewton per meter, and surface energy of the ethanol is 26 or 25. What happens? We mix it. When we mix it, then it comes to the surface. When it comes to the surface, least surface energy of ethanol quickly evaporate, and water has stronger cohesive force. It does not evaporate. It condenses. So it makes it here. So it is a kind of we can say that difference in the this surface energy of two components, and it becomes a very interesting experiment. Tears of wine.
Next, sir.
Now, very surprising, this device also tracks whether your nitrogen is extended. In the morning, someone was saying extended that conjugation. Whether the nitrogen is in the within the this benzene ring or outside. See this instruction.
Next, sir.
It seems that these polar sides of this becomes very active, and both are increasing. Important property of this device is also it tracks whether your sample acts as electrolyte or non-electrolyte. So this sample is acting as electrolyte because both are increasing.
Yes, sir.
Now this experiment we have also conducted with this device, it's a frequency. In general, what happens? This is the sodium and the ethanol solution and potassium ethanol solution and rubidium, and here this dendrimer was added. So this is highest frequency here. Highest frequency means the highest surface energy. But how, sir? Conclude.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So this also very important that it is finding the role of this ethanol. Next, sir. Quickly corrupt. Sir, equipment. Sir, it is also very remarkable experiment for study of the shear stress. We know very well that honey we take, shear stress is very least. Shear stress is very high, shear rate is very low. Shear rate is very low. Similarly, in case of, for example, blood, if shear rate is very, very low, it will not carry the oxygen quickly here and there. So it is a very important parameter, and this device accurately measures.
Next, sir.
This is microfluidics, through capillary, where both the forces, cohesive force and functional force, are accurately used.
Sir, next, sir.
We have conducted this by taking this orange peel, connected this. Sir, it flows the current.
Next, sir. Microfluidics.
This is protein, pepsin protein, taking sand, then we have added ferric chloride, then again magnetic field, unfolded. Large.
And next, surface area determined.
With this device, surface area is increased. This proves that there is an unfold.
Next,
this is the magnetic, magnetorheological fluids. Because we have fitted the magnet outside of desired strength, and then we can manipulate the protein or biomolecular activities, sir.
Next, sir.
This was the real confusion. How this frequency came in existence? This is the frequency here, means both the forces were taken into the calculation, right, sir? While in this case, only one force was taken into the calculation, only shear force. When we have taken shear force in the calculation, we found these dark areas. So it was not clear what happened, right, sir? When we have included cohesive force also in the calculation, we found a clear resolution. So this proved that this phenomena exists.
Next, sir.
This is the equation, this frequency of the sample and frequency of the medium, T by T0 viscous flow time kinetics, and T by T is the kinetic energy correction, and this was the, as I told you, non-continuum pregnant top number, and this buoyancy correction, and this equation is called Manzing equation, sir, and These are the correction terms we have calculated, 10 to power minus 7 to 10 to power minus 6, negligible. So we have omitted these terms and directly found this, and we have corrected this simple, this solvent parameter taken out, and these two are constant, D and N, and it becomes MC constant, directly proportional to N. So this very, very suitable, very potential, very effective equation, sir, which incorporates both the forces together. Till then, before this equation, separately both the forces were being dealt. So we, the potential, real interfacial potential was missing. We were not able to encash the interfacial potential of the molecules. Next, sir. Same thing, sir. See, low, least effective acidity. Next, sir. Sir, we conducted this simple experiment with the help of one biologist person. This titanium nanoparticle, highest effective acidity in the egg injected by this embryo. Because it went percolated, small size, both forces, cohesive frictional forces went to the where activities of cell division was going on, it disrupted. While other did not, other metallic nanoparticles. Next, sir. This is basically, sir, Lennard zone potential, liquid-liquid interface. Next, sir, after the other. Sir, back. It was very surprising, benzene and this cyclobenzene, it can give you the number of benzene rings in your molecules. Quickly, interfacial, liquid-liquid interfaces. Here, see, benzene and its interfacial tensor 14.32 and cyclohexane 10.59. So ultimately, we calculated. And it means benzene, it has three conjugation, pi conjugation, pi bonds. So it means it is having three and one bond is contributing this, 1.2 millimeter per liter. And if we take any unknown sample, we can easily calculate the number of pi bonds in the molecule. There's no issue at all. Next, sir. This is the same thing. It was for, again, for farmers, sir. We have taken isopropyl in water, and we in one sample we dissolved ammonium acetate, in another we dissolved sodium acetate. Very surprising, sodium acetate increased the interfacial tension. It means it is holding water together, it is not allowing water to go through the isopropyl alcohol, while ammonium acetate, it is allowing. So it is decreasing down. So this is very potential. Sir, these are the applications of interface. So it means fructohexite is very remarkable parameter. Next, sir. Are you ready? Same thing, sir. Sorry, please. Sir, again, it is this conjugation. See, we have studied, we have taken benzene, toluene, ethyl benzene. See, because of this conjugation, we thought that benzene should come here, but because of pi, sigma and pi interaction, it is more interacting towards water. So more mutual solubilization, that's why it is coming. Next, sir. Well, same thing. When we have increased the induced dye potential, iodine, larger size, it gave the same result. Because now, the induced dipole counteracted the effect of benzene. Next, sir. So same thing, sir. Same thing, sir. Sir, this is another very surprising. We have taken this, biphenyl, methane, amide, tetrachloroplatinate, ortho, meta, para. Next, sir. We found intercalation, para position, when chloride is fitted at the, is placed at the para position, it is excellently intercalating the DNA. We thought somewhere electrostatic arrangement is able to interact, is allowed this molecule to interact with the base pairs. That's why this thing, cohesive force decreases. Next, sir. We found the same ratio. This cohesive force decreased and shear increased because population increased. Next, sir. Tell you, sir. Now this back. Sir, this technology, my guide all the time insisted me, get it NPL calibrated, or it will be difficult, people not recognize, because in India people do lab pulling. So next, sir, so it is 10 times this thing. Next, sir. And sir, this is Government of India first organized workshop on this. When patent was given, immediately Government of India, this small scale industry. Next, sir. Sir, this is technology transfer directly to the Borosil and booming, and it is a paper publishing machine. Any person who any academician at college level somewhere does not have any sophisticated infrastructure, since this device gives so many parameters, your surface energy, surface area, activation energy, particle size, cohesive force, and fricohesity, and number of coagulating properties. So one can install this in the lab and publish high impact factor papers in high impact factor. I am not saying that it is my device, but it is seen. Thousands of papers are published with this device, and it is booming globally, this device. So very remarkable, and no electricity used, and no any, your sample is as such, recycled, sample is not waste, because it does not come in contact of air. It does not come in contact, you keep it little bit dark, no optical activity also, no redox activities also. So keep it is up to you. And take sample, use your sample, not waste, not rain out. So that way it is 100% sir, real green. I don't know, but it is my opinion. Next up. Sir, this was, it's a patent. Sir, now it is, one industry is taking. In fact, Borosil has taken initiative to digitalize this. Pune, they have opened one industry for digitalization, and they are taking. Next sir. Sir, this is this one book, this pen stand for. So with this, thank you very much. It will be nice if you...
Dr. Mansingh, what is the cost of that device?
Cost of the device?
Very meager.
Sir, cost of the device, sir. See, now, sir, since it is the property of the Borosil, and however, it is already mentioned in the catalog, it is in the Borosil catalog. So, probably including GST, everything, it comes about 1,10,000, 1,20,000, like this. And if some academician also request them, because they are very considerate, that they, that individual academician is very keen to conduct the research, but at present does not have the adequate resources, so he wants to take more, he demands more concession, they happily accept. In fact, they also give to the equipment. They give the equipment.
Good.
Are you contact Mansingh only, you will bring that.
Yeah.
So, gentlemen, any questions? So, since morning,